So the Guru said, I can't tell you in a nutshell. You'll have to spend some time here. At least 2 weeks you will have to spend. So she spent 2 weeks. And he taught her not only yoga, but meditation, some prayers, and so on. And she got transformed. When she went back to Hollywood, she called her husband and 2 children to a press conference. And she announced that for the first time I have discovered happiness. And the reason I discovered happiness is because of Hinduism. So I and my family are from today onwards become Hindu. Now in our country we feel a little shy to say we are Hindu. We said, no, I am not very, you know, religion is personal to me. But Hinduism, Sanatana Dharma, has taught you that how to pursue material progress after attaining at the same time harmony with spiritual values. And that is why when the Varna system was created, which is now of course become so ossified that it can't be rescued. But originally when the two rishis, Bhrigu and Bhadraja, designed the Varna system, they thought that the best way to do it is while respecting power, like military power, while respecting the power of owning land, while respecting the power of earning wealth. The main thing is the pursuit of knowledge and the sacrifice to be placed at the top. And that is the system which they felt was the most stable. And perhaps that is why this world history has known 46 civilizations. 45 of them have disappeared. The only continuing civilization of the world today is the Hindu civilization. And therefore, the development model is not that the people have not talked about it. There was a leading politician, president of the Jansangh called Dr. Upadhyay, who spoke about the need for developing the theory of integral humanism. But we got caught in the web of this materialistic philosophy of communism, socialism, capitalism, and that has to change. From now on, we must try to work out a theory, a new model where material progress and spiritual advancement are both blended together and harmonized together. Let me tell you, in China, the Communist Party has recently adopted a resolution that China henceforth will believe in harmonious society. And in that harmonious society, they have said Buddhism and Confucianism, these two will be revived. And today, the process of revival of Buddhism and Confucian is taking place in China because they found that material progress produces greed, produces envy, jealousy, it creates tension in society, and therefore they needed these values to be brought in. And therefore I would say the world will ultimately move towards this new alternative model which has been there from our time immemorial in our culture. Thank you.
एकस्मिन् गणे बहवः प्रश्नाः सन्ति परन्तु तत्र प्रश्नस्य किञ्चित् अस्पष्टता अथवा असमीचीनतया इत्युक्ते मम अभिप्रायः इफ् यू कम् टु पवर् इति सर्वं लिखितमस्ति ऐ थिङ्क् वि हेव् टु यु आर् कमिङ्ग् टु पवर् यु आर् कमिङ्ग् टु दिस् इज् इट् फार् मी इज् इट् गिव् फार् मे सो द क्वेश्चन् इस् all these persons are saying if you make it for the power and the Indian government, the BJP government is formed, all these are saying again and again. But the question that they are asking is, what can we do from a government perspective through the domain of Sanskrit? That's the spirit of the question. I don't want to read all the questions. But that's the spirit of the question. So let me ask this, I don't want to ask.
Well, first of all, there's a lot one can do if you are in government for Sanskrit. Let me add one thing about Tamil. I once took out a dictionary produced by the die-hard what are people called as the Dravidian movement people. This Dravida is not a Tamil word, it's a Sanskrit word. Adi Shankara invented. But these foolish people here listened to the British and adopted Dravidian. But these so-called Dravida movement people produced a pure Tamil edition. And I took it out and I counted the words which have Sanskrit similarities, like Anubhavam is in Tamil, it is Anubhavam from Sanskrit. So there are a lot of common words. So I put out, I found 43% of the Tamil words in pure Tamil were from Sanskrit. So I showed it to Karunanidhi once when I met him. I said, listen, I have done this tabulation, it shows that Sanskrit, even your Tamil, so-called pure Dravidian Tamil, has 43% of our words in Sanskrit. He says, no, 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 where do we use it? I say, your own name, Karunanidhi, is a Sanskrit word. Yeah. And this Pali symbol is called Chinnam, which is Sanskrit for Chin. And it is Udaya Suriya. Now that was a Sanskrit. So, unfortunately, he tried to escape by saying, no, Sanskrit stole it from Tamil. Why so you won't know, only know for stealing, but this is the fact of the matter is, today the spoken Tamil has so many words in common with Sanskrit. Now, what needs to be done is to begin with make Sanskrit as an optional language and to encourage as was pointed out just now, encourage these Sanskrit words to move more and more to every language, particularly Hindi, and therefore make Hindi, transform Hindi into a language so close to Sanskrit that the transition to Sanskrit is made. So if the government decides, it is easy, people will fall in line, and I think we have to do it. We have to explain to people how Sanskrit is now being made compulsory for certain courses in America, in Britain, how Sanskrit has become considered the language most compliant for computers. So therefore, any government can do it. And in my opinion, within 3 years, Sanskrit can emerge as a big language of India.
Four interesting questions. I think I put it to all the three panelists and request you to. First question is, English cannot capture the spirit and sense of Sanskrit words, which is fine. But the same is what is said by scholars of Arabic, and every language seems to say that Arabic, English, what importance and greatness of their own languages, that their languages have what qualities and so on. How do we explain it? So each language have their own claim identities. So in that context, how do we look at Sanskrit? Is that how do we appear to know Sanskrit as a much overarching kind of position? Is the first question. And read a couple of other questions also we can. Second question is also interesting. What is the mindset that is Indian? Because we talked about Indians. What is the mindset that is Indian? Is English or Arabic never going to be Indian? So all these are related to why do we approach from different languages? Can we approach very different other than Indian is the question, it's like in both ways. If you have any answers to these questions. There is meanwhile, there is a third question which I would like Shastriji to answer in think about it. Why is Sanskrit scholars weak in selling and marketing, promoting as much as the opposition is doing? And why Indians are weak at confronting opposition as Arabic and English and Muslim speakers of India? So I think all these issues are looking at Sanskrit in the context of other competing languages. That's how see the spirit of this question is, and if you can have some thoughts on it.
Each language has a cultural history. English has a cultural history of its own. You cannot express the spirit of Indian culture through English language. That's not the point I am trying to make. This problem one experience, when one tries to translate a literary work as a literary writer, I give it as an example. It is easy to translate a Kannada novel or a Kannada poem into Marathi or Hindi or Gujarati or Telugu or Malayalam. But it is very difficult to translate it into English. We think that we know English, but what kind of English do we know? We know only business English. The English that we read in our book every day, we read more English newspapers than of course other. But that is not clear English, that is not correct English. That does not reflect our culture. In literature, we express our culture most deeply. In philosophy, we express our culture most deeply. When you offer an analysis of our language, of our usage, you have to express it in our language, the language which our music itself has created, language which our dance itself has created. Therefore, it's a question of culture. It is very difficult. There is a complaint always saying Indian literary works will not catch the Europeans, because there are no book translators. There are no book translators because of this impediment, because of the cultural gap. Therefore, it is better always to have one Indian language as the base, and that base language is Sanskrit. Because you may say Hindi, okay, Hindi. Yes, Hindi is spoken by a large number of people, that is true. But Hindi itself is a derivative language, a derivative of Sanskrit. Therefore, why not have Sanskrit? That's my point.
So the other question is, why is the Sanskrit domain very poor in Marathi? And what is the issue there?
Uttama. Prachina Bharate kadapi samskrutasya selling marketing nasi. It was never commercialized. Samskrit was vidya danam, anna danam, aushadi danam. Three things were never marketed. So vidya marketing. Atama samskruta janaha adhya api marketing na kurbanti. मार्केटिंग इत्यस्य अत्यन्तं कॉन्टेक्स्ट् मध्ये भवान् वदति ऐ एग्री तत्र संस्कृतजनानां शास्त्रसंरक्षणं भाषा तत्र पठन पाठनं तत्रैव मग्नता अस्ति मार्केटिंग् एक्स्पर्ट्स् अनन्तरं लेङ्ग्वेज् एक्स्पर्ट्स् मिलन्ति चेत् मार्केटिङ्ग् शीघ्रं भवति प्रतिदानीं शीघ्रं करणीयं ये मार्केटिङ्ग् एक्स्पर्ट्स् सन्ति कृपया
समयस्य अभावः केवलं प्रश्नद्वयम् इतोपि अग्रे अहं प्रेषयामि समापयामः. देर् इस् वन् सेट् आफ़् क्वश्चन्स् आल् दीस् क्वश्चन्स् अगेन् टाक् अबौट् चेञ्जिङ्ग् द एजुकेशन् सिस्टम्. यस् नो डाक्टर् सुब्रह्मण्यं स्वामीजि आल्सो सेड् देट् वी शुड् बि एबल् टीच् सन्स्क्रिट् इन् अ बिग् वे. सो आल् दीस् क्वश्चन्स् आर् आस्किङ्ग् how can Sanskrit be implemented in the school curriculum? How can we have a system of education? Should we go to Gurukula system of education? It's another question. Is it possible to introduce Sambhashana, Sanskrita Sambhashana in every school from first standard itself? Etadrisha Prashnaha Santi. So can I request some thoughts on it? How do we actually go about getting Sanskrit into, what is the policy? The other is some of the issues of how do we go about. Is there any thoughts on that?
Yes, it is possible. For example, there is a school called Gurukula Prabodhini near Koppa. I have visited that. There, the children Sanskrit is not a difficult language if it is spoken even at the early age. It is easy to grasp.
There are quite a few questions. I would simply read the questions just to tell you what kind of anxiety are there in the minds of people. We have answers, but what of time I don't think we, I don't want to get into each of those questions. There are questions which says, you know, can we comment on German versus Sanskrit? There are questions about global warming, unification of the nuclear family system. Is there solutions which we can take from the ancient Indian wisdom? There are questions, what is in Veda, which is scientific Veda, if we are software engineering, we have created complete architecture and product for aircraft. We want to make products for India using ancient knowledge and Veda. Etadisha Krishna, there are different questions like this. I think one of the things that I can tell you is Sanskrit Bharati, in conjunction with all Sanskrit organizations in the country, they are doing a lot of work on this. Please contact Sanskrit Bharati, we will get enough answers for this. So I do not want to individually take all these questions. With these few words, there are other set of questions for Dr. Subramanian Swamy. They are very political in nature. So please bear with me for one of time. I do not ask these questions. I am sure there is an opportunity to ask a little later. With these few words, thank you very much for sharing your thoughts and asking your questions. Let me take a couple of minutes to just conclude this wonderful vichara question. Before that, I want to make a couple of announcements. There is one Shree Mani Kumar who has left his ATM card at the Shree Priti shop. He is collecting back. This is an Asian Shree. I am also delighted to tell you that Bhyrappa ji is our Prachara Sanskrita Chatra. This is the greatness of Shri Bhyrappa ji, and it is also the greatness of the movement. No, that is how the whole thing happens. So, you too can, why I am saying this, every one of you can become. Then Bhyrappa ji's family can get into Sanskrit, why not every one of us? I think we can have correspondence course in Tamil, Hindi, Kannada, Telugu, Malayalam, Gujarati. It's very affordable. Please go and ask, you'll be able to get more and more information on that. Finally, I want to also show you this beautiful magazine which I have been reading for the last 15 years, Sambhashana Sandesha. All contemporary politics, stories, everything in Sanskrit. This is also available. If you want to buy, you can subscribe yourself. There's a wonderful way to actually improve Sanskrit. Varaha Pichati, Sanskritam, Dashadina, Shidram, Maya, Gata, Katupani, Sanskrita, Sambhashana, Sivata, Bhasha, Yata, Jnana, Sivata, So these few words, it's my pleasure to take a couple of minutes to just conclude this vichara goshti. Asyam vichara goshtiyam mahodayah bhinna bhinna vishayam upasthapitaah antah santi vayam sarve mahaan santushtaah tadartham prashnottararupena अन्य केचन विषयाः अपि उपस्थापिताः सन्ति येषां सर्वान् सज्जीकृत्य संक्षेपेण अस्माभिः इदानीं किञ्चित् चर्चां कृतं समयस्य अभावः दीस् गुड् थिङ्ग्स् नीड् एनार्मस् टैम् बट् देर् आर् प्राक्टिकालिटीस् टु देट् सो देर्फोर् ऐ मस्ट् ब्रिङ्ग् दिस् टु एन् एण्ड् सो इट्स् आल्सो मै प्रौड् प्लेशर् अण्ड् प्रिविलेज् टु एक्स्प्रेस् मै सिन्सियर् थाङ्क्स् अण्ड् ग्राटिट्यूड् आन् बिहाफ् आफ़् संस्कृत भारती the eminent speakers for the day. First of all, we gratitude to Mr. Subramanian Swamiji. Because in the era of fast-paced political and economic developments that is happening in this country, if he can take one whole day and be with us, that is ample evidence of the love, the support and the interest that he has on Sanskrit papers. So we are eternally grateful to sir for that and we look forward to his success for the years to come. Bhyrappa ji is a great intellect of this state, great lover of Sanskrit, and again amount of time. I know that he came early in the morning, the amount of time he has spent with us, and such intellectuals are very important for furthering the cause of Sanskrit. I am extremely thankful to you, sir, for taking the then this entire team of Sanskrit Bharati for the last 30 years, we are really marching and marching on this journey of Sanskrit. Still, to accept your request to come and sit on stage and share his thoughts, thank you very much for that. And happy thank you to Nagan Ji for all the time and effort that he has taken under. It's very important for me to thank the Swamijis from Shastry Ashram. Not only that, they were able to be here and participate in the activity, but to give us all the support. Because unless we get such a nice campaign, these things do not really go as we planned. And thank you to them for all that. And thank you to all of you.
Thank you.